going to take a look at our laminar flow HEPA filter for mycology purposes. I'm going to go ahead and unbox it here. It comes to you this way. Well packed with peanuts and such. I suggest you save the cardboard in the rubber pan to protect the filter when you're not using it when you store it. So this is a 13 by 15 inch filter system. We've actually designed this around a commonly available low cost HEPA filter. It's a 99.7% removal at 0.3 microns. We built special test equipment to characterize the filter system so we can produce truly laminar flow with this filter. It's an aluminum housing that we actually manufacture here in our facility. We plasma cut the parts and then press brake bend them. It's all CNC technology, and then they're assembled. So we'll just take a look around here. You can see it's a nice little compact unit. When it comes to you, the cord is bundled. You want to cut this wire tie. And you operate it simply by, I like to have this oriented, you operate it simply by just plugging it in. Plug it in when you use it, unplug it when you don't use it. So here's our little work area, suitable for to do our agar work right here. I think if you, you can stand it up on the edge, if you're going to inoculate grain bags, it gives you a little more working distance here to play around. So that's basically it. It's a pretty self-explanatory basic unit that's suitable for home users. If you purchase the filter unit with the optional cover and work surface, it'll come like this. Simply just a friction fit, and you simply just pull it off. And you can set this work surface up just like this, which elevates you off the table and right into the laminar flow stream. So you can, again, do your agar work. So after you've used this filter for many hundreds or thousands of hours, you may need to replace it. It's a common HEPA filter. The instructions have the part number in there. You can get it from Amazon for about $20 for a set of the filter itself and the pre-filters. There's actually two pre-filters behind it that are critical to establishing the laminar flow. So when you change it, you want to make sure you use all the components as they're in here. It's pretty straightforward and simple to change. There's these bars that go all around. They hold the filter in. Two screws on each of them. So you remove those screws, take all four off, the filter simply comes right out. Put the new pre-filters and the HEPA filter in and replace these bars. They're slotted, so these move back and forth. So you're going to tension it up a little bit just to hold the filter in, to seal against the foam seal that's behind it. And that's all you need to do to change it. Reasonably, you shouldn't have to change this for several years. I suggest not leaving it plugged in permanently, because then you're just going to use up your filter. Only operate the device when you